sorry to impose on you two. It's just that I'm desperate and everyone I usually count on has abandoned me. Jason, Lucky, even Dante. But Dante will do whatever Lulu wants because he's Lulu's boyfriend. And if I ask her, she's going to ask him. And then, never mind, everybody's out of town.
Well, where did Dante go?
I don't know. He and Lulu didn't give me specifics. But the only thing I care about right now is that Robin's disappeared. And we think she's been kidnapped. Look, I want you to use all of your mob connections to try to find her.
Lisa Niles just showed up at GH.
Great. Let's go question her.
No. No, that was Patrick. He wants to spend some time with her, see if he can get her to slip up and reveal where she was tonight.
Yeah, I'm not sure that's a good idea.
You don't hear me arguing. But Patrick's convinced that this is the only thing that will work. He knows her better than we do. I told him I'd give him an hour, and then we're taking over. In the meantime, I want her car impounded and her apartment searched.
Yeah, but we don't have a warrant or even probable cause.
I don't give a damn about that. All right?
Mac, you can't build a case like this.
You're not listening to me. I know my niece. Robin didn't just wander away from Emma, and there's no indication that she was disoriented from a head injury. That leaves Lisa. She took her. We need to find out where.
So you're willing to cross the line on this?
I don't give a damn about court cases or rules of evidence. I want to find Robin. We got.
We're impounding Lisa Niles' car from the parking structure at the hospital.
What about her apartment?
We sent a forensics team over and they'll call us if they find anything. You know, which is not going to matter, Mac, because even if they find a detailed blueprint on how to kidnap Robin, signed and dated by Lisa Niles, it's not going to be admissible in court.
I want to find Robin. I don't care if I can prove it in court. If you're not on board with that, let me know now. I can reassign the case.
If Lisa Niles did take your niece, well, then she did a hell of a job of covering her tracks. She's a smart girl, which means she's dangerous.
Yeah, so we need to stay one step ahead of her.
Mac, if it were me, I would tell Patrick Drake to go shove it. Okay, seriously, I mean, what does he know about drilling a suspect? Huh? I would go over there right now, and I would ambush the two of them and drag Lisa out kicking and screaming. Because an hour in a circumstance like this, it could be the difference between finding Robin safe or her little girl ending up without a mother.
I know it's a lot, me asking you to use your mob power just because I'm asking, but Robin is missing.
What about the cops?
Yeah, Max all over it, but we need all the help we can get.
Yeah, of course, I'll help. If you want to leave, I understand.
I'm not going anywhere.
What makes you think that Robin was kidnapped?
Do you know Lisa Niles, the doctor that was working with Patrick?
Yeah, pretty blonde. I've seen her at Jake's.
Well, I guess she and Patrick had a thing while Robin was out of town. Anyway, when Robin got back, Lisa totally went off the rails and she started doing all this crazy stuff, like making it look like Robin tried to run her down with her car, or taking Emma's favorite stuffed animal and boiling it in the hospital lab and making it look like Robin did it. She even took Emma without anyone's permission.
Okay, Maxie, I'm sorry, I gotta ask this, but is there any chance you could be exaggerating here? I mean, I saw Lisa Niles in action the night that Ethan got shot and she seemed pretty sane to me.
No, Lisa's just smart enough to cover her own tracks. I mean, she made Robin look like the psycho one.
And when did she disappear?
They found her car off the road on Route 9. Emma was strapped into her car seat, but Robin was nowhere to be found. What are you thinking?
I was with you that night that Robin stashed her baby in a tree and took off.
Robin had postpartum depression then. She's fine now, better than fine.
Did she know about her husband's affair? I'm just saying, Maxie, information like that could crush somebody emotionally. Maybe it's possible Robin took off on her own.
Dr. Niles, I need to speak with you.
Why?
Regarding Robin's disappearance.
Well, I don't know where she is. I was at a movie this evening.
What movie?
What's going on?
Whoa. Hey, wait a minute.
I'm taking Dr. Niles down to the station to discuss her actions towards Robin.
Are you okay with this? You're just going to let him come in here and harass our staff members?
Dr. Niles, I haven't decided yet. Let's go.
Mac, hey! Mac!
He might have just ruined my chance to find out where Robin is.
Robin is a rational person. Yes, she has had her heart broken and Patrick cheated on her, but she's been dealing with it.
It's just a little bit hard to believe that a respected doctor like Lisa Miles would be capable of doing all those demented things.
Look, I know what it's like to fall for someone so hard that you lose all sense of what's right and wrong. I mean, one minute you're stealing pills to enable his addiction, the next you're faking a pregnancy so he won't go back to his wife. I mean, you rationalize that it's worth it.
Are you sure you're not projecting your own crap onto Lisa?
I recognize Lisa. I know what I did, but I think Lisa's capable of much worse. And if I'm right, she took Robin and left Emma in that car by herself.
Like I said, I will do anything and everything I can to help.
Thank you.
And information is key. All right, maybe somebody saw Lisa somewhere.
Well, I'll let you know if I hear anything.
Okay.
Thanks.
Just you and me now. No one can hear us. So you can drop the act and tell me where the hell is Robin.
This is where you're supposed to assure me that I have the right to an attorney.
Yeah, soon enough. First you tell me, where is Robin?
I don't know.
You know, this isn't going good for you.
I'm sorry, you're right. I'm hung up on how rude you've been. I mean, you embarrassed me at my workplace. You dragged me here in handcuffs. Okay, but when I put my indignation aside and I just take a breath, I see that you are just frantic because you lost someone you love, and I can only imagine how that feels. So I will tell you what I know. Nothing. Not a clue. I have no idea what happened to Robin.
I don't believe you.
I didn't know that Robin had crashed her car until Dr. Weber had told me. I didn't know that she'd abandoned her daughter.
She didn't. Robin would never have left Emma alone.
Okay, you hate me. I get it. All right, I'm Patrick's lover. I'm the home wrecker. All right, go on. Hate me all you want, but I can't let you railroad me for something that I didn't do.
You know something? You're not the first whack job I've ever dealt with. Ryan Chamberlain, Faith Roscoe, Jerry Jacks, you are an amateur compared to them. So this little act where you pretend to be normal, it doesn't fly. I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get the truth out of you.